Ruth's crew, hello and welcome back. We're inside today. It's turned a little chilly, hasn't it? I wonder, have any of you been back to school this week? I know a few people have. I wonder how it was. Before we get started today, I want you to know that you are all invited, always, to Ruth's crew. You're always welcome. I'm going to do the name call out now, and I hope I've got everybody. But if I miss you, I'm really sorry. So here we go. Martha, hello. Valentine, hello. May, hello. Reuben, hi there. Simon, hello. Hazel, lovely to see you. Toby, hello. Tess, hi there. Eliza, how lovely to see you. Lucy, Meredith. Winnie, hi there. Edward, hello. Gregory, hello. Kippy, hi. Jemima, fantastic to see you. Elsie, hello. Ralph, hello. Rollo, hello. Hope, hi there. Sophie, hello. Alex, hi. Maisie, hello. Lucas, hello. Anna, great to see you. Billy, hi. Freddie, hello. Hugo, hi there. Isaiah, hello. Maisie, hello. Holly, hello. Grace, hi there. Wilbur, hello. I think that's everybody. I hope that's everybody. Hello, you're all really welcome. Now then, Penny is going to tell us our story today. And she seems to be getting ready for a party. Have a look.
Right, I've just got a few things to do. It's my party today, and I've just got to get the table finished. My friends will be here soon. So I've invited Sam, he's a lot. Lucy's so nice. Toby's really fun. Joe is my best friend, and Molly is really cool. So we've got all the plates. Okay, Bella has a few snacks. Look, lots of snacks, they're a hungry lot. And we've got candles for the cake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I reckon, maybe just one more balloon. Right, I think we're pretty much ready. All I've got to do now is wait for them to arrive.
Now, I was thinking, I love a party. I love getting ready for a party. I love choosing what to wear. And it's been so long since we've been able to go to a party. Well, I've had some fun choosing what to wear. Do-do! Hi! I'm party ready! I'm in the mood for a royal party. Perhaps it's a posh party with furs and hats. Maybe it's a wedding party. Maybe it's a beach-themed party where sparkle is required. I wonder what you like to wear to a party. I wonder what puts you in the mood for celebration and rejoicing. Right, to get us in the mood for a party, I think we need some song and some movement. So here's one of our action songs. Find a space and party along with a cartoon character.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
most about a party? Do you like the cake? Is it the balloons? One of the things I love about a party is being together with lots of people and having some music. And at the moment, we can't do that, can we? Only six of us can gather in one space outside, and we've all got to be 2 metres apart. That got me thinking. If you could invite six people, well, it would be five people and you, to a party, who would you invite? Would it be your bestest friends? Who are you missing most? Would it be Granny? Would it be a teacher from school? Maybe not. Who are you missing most? Who would you invite to a party? Who would make it fun? Would it be somebody that always was good at singing, or always was good at dancing, or always told good jokes? Do you know somebody like that? Would it be somebody that was really good at listening to you? Who would be so good at a party? Well, Jesus told a story about a party. Let's see what happened. Penny tells us the story.
Jesus told a story about a party. But first of all, I wondered if you could help me with the story. So, whenever I say party, I want you to cheer like this. Hooray! Okay, should we practice? So, a man was going to have a party. Hooray! Excellent. Right, now we're ready. Maybe you can help me with some of the other actions as well. Okay, so Jesus told this story. Once there was a man who decided he was going to throw a party for all of his friends. He sent out the invitations and then he got ready. He cleaned the house. He swept the floor. He got the food ready. He made a cake and he got the decorations. Okay. Then he sat and waited. Nobody came. He wondered what had happened. So he sent out his servant. The servant went to the first man and knocked on the door.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry I can't. I've just got a new field that I need to look after. I'm afraid I really can't come to the party.
Then the servant went to another guest and knocked on the door.
I'm really sorry. Is it today? Oh, thanks for the invite. But look, I've got these two beautiful little calves, little cows, and I've got to take them out to a field as soon as possible. Aren't they beautiful? They're Daisy and Maisie. I'm afraid I can't come today. Maybe next week, if you do it again, that would be really lovely. Okay then, bye!
He went to the third guest and knocked on the door.
Today. Oh, sorry. We've only just got married.
The servant came back to tell his master that no one was coming to his party. He was angry. So he said to his servant, okay, you go out into all the streets and invite anyone you can find. Invite the poor, the lame, the lonely, the sad, anyone you can find. I want them to come to be my special guests. Jesus told this story to his disciples to explain that being friends with God every day and forever was like being invited to the best party ever. God loves everyone and invites us all to be part of his family. But some people are like the guests in the story, and they think they're too busy and they say no to God. But God keeps asking them, keeps looking for them, and keeps inviting them to come. We decide whether we're going to say yes or no to God's invitation. But God has amazing plans for all of us that say yes. And it's like being in a wonderful party every day. Forevermore.
So in that story, the kingdom of God was being described as this banquet to which people were invited. But the people that were first invited made excuses. So in the end, the master sent the servant out to bring everybody in to make it a party. Everybody is invited to God's party. God longs to have you come and celebrate with him in worship, where he can pour his Holy Spirit down and cheer your hearts. He loves us to join together and worship him. So, we better do it. Earlier in the week when it was sunny, I had another go at my lighthouse in the garden. Find a space, let's enjoy it.
My resting in my doubts, in my failures, you walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are my peace in my troubled sea. You are my peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In my question, your truth will hold. Your great love will see me through. You are the peace in my troubles evil. You are my peace in the troubles sea.
excuses for not going to the party, didn't they? Now, I do hope you're not going to make any excuses for not praying and being with God this week. I hope none of you have bought some cows recently or got married. Or maybe you bought a field. Who knows? But we all have excuses for not spending time with God. We're feeling too tired, we've got too much schoolwork, there's something good on the telly, we're feeling hungry, we'd rather go for a run. Don't make those excuses. God is inviting you every day to spend some time with him. So set aside a little bit of time, get on your party gear, maybe, or maybe make a party cake, and spend some time with God, knowing that he's invited you. He wants to be with you. Now, it's really tough at the moment, this lockdown season, and not being able to meet together and have a party together. But it doesn't stop us being able to invite people to be with God. So maybe you could invite a friend to watch Ruth's Crew and to join in with the fun we've been having at Ruth's Crew. Who could you invite? Have a think. Maybe God will give you a chance this week. Either at a distance to shout across the road, "Hey, check out Ruth's Crew, our church, it's great." Or maybe you can text them or get mum or dad to text them. Or maybe you can make a little invitation. You are invited to party with God every week at Ruth's Crew. It's worth a try, isn't it? And then if they let me know their names, we can shout out new names and we can be together in this way. And I hope and pray that soon we can be together properly and have a real party. In our story, everyone was invited to the banquet. And I want us to pray that everyone we meet, we can invite to be with God and celebrate with God. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful story of your kingdom. The story of how you want to have a feast and how we're all invited. Please help us not to make excuses, not to avoid spending time with you. Because when we do, when we pray and when we worship, your Holy Spirit has chance to lift our hearts and to pour joy and peace into our lives. Thank you that Jesus Christ, your Son, told stories of the parties you want to have. Help us be people that are always ready to invite others to be with you. Amen. There's a lovely colouring to download from the website of a party happening, a lovely feast. So enjoy colouring that in. Oh, next week is Eco Church. We've not done that before, but we're going to have a week in Main Church and in Ruth's Crew, thinking about God's creation and how we can best honour God and give God glory. So, I was wondering if you had any pictures, any ways in which you saw God's glory in creation. So if you do have anything you'd like to share, a photograph of something beautiful that you have seen, or a piece of artwork about God's beautiful world that you would like to share, please email it to me so we can share it next week when we celebrate all of God's glory. And on that note, I wanted us to finish with a worship song that we used right at the beginning of all this lockdown stuff, and it's all about God's creation and that it's good. I hope you enjoy this song. I'm going to play out with it. Bye. See you next week.